Hey there! Welcome to Life Noggin. Imagine waking up in the middle of the night, being fully conscious, then realizing you can't move a muscle. Your chest tightens, and it gets hard to breathe. You start hallucinating, and a dark figure begins moving towards you. You try to scream for help, but you can't. Are you dying? Are you dreaming? Then, all of a sudden, you can move again. That terrifying apparition is gone, and you can breathe normally. Believe it or not, experiences like this are fairly common. This is a medical condition called sleep paralysis, and about 8% of the population has experienced some variation of it in their lives. While this can be absolutely terrifying, scientists say it isn't dangerous. Phew. People used to think that this paralysis was caused by supernatural beings like demons holding people down while they sleep. Since hallucinations are fairly common with this condition, it's understandable that people would think the thing they saw was what was stopping them from moving. But there's actually a very scientific, not-so-supernatural explanation for why some people wake up and can't move. When we sleep, we experience cycles of REM sleep and non-REM sleep. Rapid eye movement sleep is when your eyes move quickly from one side to the other. This is the time of night when parts of your brain, like the thalamus and the amygdala, are most active. Usually, people wake up when their brains are in the non-REM phase, but sometimes you wake up when you're still in REM sleep. This is what prompts sleep paralysis. During REM sleep, neurotransmitters like GABA and glycine basically turn off your muscles to make sure you don't act out your dreams. So if you wake up before a REM cycle is over, your muscles are still sleeping, so you can't move, even if you're fully awake. Your chest muscles are turned off too, with the exception of your diaphragm. That's why people experience shortness of breath or feel pressure on their chest. When your brain is in REM mode, your dreams are the most vivid. In sleep paralysis, your mind is still partially dreaming, leading you to hallucinations that can feel super real. People experience visual, sensory, and auditory hallucinations, but they disappear once the paralysis is over, usually after a couple of minutes. Sleep paralysis is thought to be caused by sleep deprivation, certain medications, sleep disorders like sleep apnea and narcolepsy, stress, and altered sleep patterns, like working night shifts. If you're between the ages of 10 and 25, you're more likely to experience it, and people with mental disorders like PTSD, anxiety, and depression are also at a higher risk of having the condition. But while all of this sounds really scary, researchers recently found that 20% of people who experience sleep paralysis on a regular basis actually find it pleasant. Since it's not dangerous, they relax and just let it happen. Scientists are also investigating whether there's a genetic link to this condition. Twin studies have pointed towards yes, but there is still more research to be done. Unfortunately, there's no cure for this, but doctors suggest regulating your sleep schedule and avoiding drugs and alcohol before bed. Sleeping on your back also contributes to the problem, so maybe try a different position. In serious cases, an antidepressant may be prescribed, but this condition isn't permanent or dangerous. Curious to know why it's sometimes so difficult to fall asleep? Check out this video. Well, aside from worrying about that one thing that you did in middle school several years ago, it might have something to do with what you're eating. Drinks and food with caffeine can cause sleep disturbances, especially when you have them close to bedtime. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.